themes. We have one one-act night this year. This is my first year here. So we kind of, we went back and forth on what to do with that, whether we lean towards the drama or lean towards the comedy. And this class of actors is so stinking ambitious that when I started giving them scripts to read and looking at things to go through, they're like, let's just do it all. So that's what we're gonna do. We have a little bit of comedy. We're leaning towards the comedy edge a little bit, but there's some dramatic stories, some dramatic moments that should provoke some thought. When's the last time anybody in here saw like live theater somewhere? Like, how many of you have seen it in the last 2 months? Anything live, like real people in front of you? A few, but it's a small minority. So, there's nothing like watching people with blood running through their veins 6 feet from you when they could like fall or barf or whatever. Like, there's this vulnerability to it that's just wonderful. So we just ask a couple things of you. We try to do everything we can to make, I like to joke about this room, we try to make a room that's designed to eat bologna sandwiches in, sort of tenable as a theater. We do everything we can. So we like cell phones to not make noise in the middle of the plays. And if you could just try to uphold kind of a normal theater etiquette when the play gets started and everything, just sit back, relax, and enjoy it. If we see shiny faces in the crowd from cell phones and stuff, that's a little distracting. So, you know, live a little. Put it on silent or turn it off if you're really crazy. I think you'll be okay. So, a little bit about our show tonight. And I have a cheater card because I'm not very good at this. I welcome them. I said cell phones, theater things. Oh yeah, so we started off the night with zero change. So if you came in and there was no one taking your money or no one there were change, just there's three intermissions that are all gonna be pretty short tonight. Our scene changes are quick. So make your way over to the ticket table and Scouts Honor, pay your way if you did not, please. Okay, so a little bit about the stories tonight. We have the theme that we kind of picked up on is that these are all dealing with a stage of life. Some stage of life. Some of them are pretty common, like death or marriage. These are things that lots of people have written about, playwrights, novelists, songwriters, a lot. And then we have a couple things that are kind of less often talked about, like eternity and the time that we deal with a lot at Berean at any high school, where kids are freshmen and they feel like they're babies almost compared to seniors. And then when you get to the senior year thing, it's like you're on greased rails and you gotta figure out what you wanna do with your life, and there's all these people speaking at you from every direction, and you gotta decide what you wanna be for the rest of your life right now, it almost seems like. So we have one story that addresses that. They're not in any particular order, so you're kind of, you know, just hang in there, it'll be fine. The interesting thing to me also, and you might pick up on this, every one of these plays has something in it that's just recently obsolete. The first one is the newspaper. We don't really read those anymore. The second one is a radio. We all have our, you know, phones and podcasts and Spotify, whatever's, and that's also obsolete. A brochure makes an appearance in one of these, and we all go on websites now, right? We don't really look at brochures. And then lastly, a watch, which I have a watch on, but 9 times out of 10 I pull my phone out to check the time. So just a funny little tune. Let's pray, and then we're gonna get started. We hope you enjoy it. Feel free to laugh. There's plenty of moments to do that. So let's pray. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for a type of worship, God, that is different from the other types of worship that we're able to participate in, God. Pray that all the hard work that's gone into this would be for your glory and not for my glory or any of these students' glory, God, but that we would want to be excellent. We would want to entertain tonight and provoke thought because you have saved us, because we owe everything to you from here on out, God, for the rest of our lives. We pray that you would allow us to have fun tonight and be joyful with the joy that only you can provide, and that you would just be with every moment of this production and let it be received in a way that is glorifying you as well. In your name we pray. Amen. Enjoy.
What a rare mood I'm in. Why, it's almost like being in love. There's a smile on my face for the whole human race. Why, it's almost like being in love. All the music.
Carol, could you come out here for a moment, please?
Just a second, dear.
What are you doing in there?
You'll see in a minute.
Oh, all right.
It's a surprise.
I won't go in there, I promise.
Did you need something?
Yes, I have a bit of a headache coming on, but you won't let me go into the bathroom to get an aspirin.
I'll get one for you.
Thank you, dear.
No problem. Why do you have a headache?
I don't know. I guess I've just been busier than usual.
Peter, dear, we seem to be all out of aspirin, but here is a glass of water for you.
Thank you, dear.
I have to go get my dress down from the cleaner so I can get you more when I do that.
Thank you, honey.
Let me kiss it better.
You want to know something?
What?
I love you just as much today as the day I married you.
I love you more. Can you believe it was 10 years ago?
Where does the time go?
Who knows? It's been a great 10 years, hasn't it?
It really has. I can't think of a single other couple as happy as us after this long.
Happy anniversary, Peter.
Happy anniversary, sweetheart.
Which reminds me, I have to get your surprise out of the bedroom.
You don't have another man in there, do you? Oh. I can out-kiss him any day.
Oh, yeah, you're good.
Excuse me?
Just in it.
This won't take long, will it? I have the reservations at the Hilton for 8, remember?
No, no, not long at all.
What time is it now?
Oh, it's only noon. You got plenty of time.
All right. You run along to the bedroom and get your surprise ready.
All right.
Oh, and if the doorbell rings, just stay in there.
Okay.
I love you, dear.
Right back at you.
Oh, she's gonna love it. I know she will. I got it, honey! Oh, it's just you two.
I told you we shouldn't have come over. They'll be busy, I said. They'll be having a romantic day, I said. They won't want visitors, I said. But oh no, you had to come over and wish them a happy anniversary. You've never wished me a happy anniversary, Steve. We've been married 10 years and you've never wished me a happy anniversary. Why don't you come over and marry Peter and Carol, huh? You seem to like them more than you do me.
Hello, Peter.
Hello, Vicky.
We'll be going. I told him.
Oh no, it's fine. I'm sorry for sounding a little disappointed earlier. It's just that I've been expecting something all morning.
A parcel, a package, a person? What is it? What are you expecting?
Vicky, be quiet. That's none of your business.
It is my business. I'm Carol's best friend. I deserve to know what's coming in and out of this house. I refuse to be left in the dark like you, Steve.
Carol's in the bedroom. She's getting some surprise ready. I'm sure you could go in there.
Oh, good. I will. I'm sure she'll tell me what's going on. Men have no idea how to communicate. Steve, don't be rude. Take off the hat. I'll be about a minute. Steve, I said take off the hat! Carol, I'm here!
Thanks, Peter.
For what?
The aspirin. I've been helping out lately.
So you're the one who took it. So what's got into her lately?
She always gets this way when she's pregnant. One minute she's crying about the cookies being burned, and the next she's yelling at me for not eating them. I don't know whether I'm coming or going.
Incredible. I have no idea how a baby can have such an effect on me.
Hormones are a tricky business. Take my advice and never have children with Carol. They destroy your marriage.
Steve, you know how happy Carol and I are.
And you know how happy Vicky and I were. But the second you put a bun in the oven, she puts you on the back burner. And there you'll sit, the rest of your life simmering away. Ever getting hotter, ever getting cooler.
Steve, it's a big day!
Why, what do we do?
Not you and me, Carol and me.
I'm sorry, it's just the only time I catch a boil is when I'm out of that house.
I just want this to be a special day.
Well, you got any big plans for tonight?
Have I got big plans? I'll tell you what I got planned. First, I'm taking Carol out to the Hilton at 8 for a candlelight dinner she'll never forget. And then, we're gonna spend a night in the honeymoon suite.
Does she know?
Well, she knows about the room and the dinner. But what she doesn't know about is I bought her something she's been wanting for years.
There's more?
Yep. I finally bought her an engagement ring.
But you're already married. Think romantically, Steve.
I don't know how.
I know. She put it in your Christmas card. Anyways, when we first got married, I didn't have enough money to buy her a proper engagement ring. After a few years, she stopped hounding me for one. But this year, business being the way it is, I finally decided to buy her the diamond she's always wanted.
Peter, you've really outdone yourself.
There's more.
More?
Yep. Carol is always telling me to wear my wedding band. But the darn thing always turns my skin green.
Green?
You see, when we first got married, Carol demanded that we both have wedding bands. I bought her the wedding band she wanted, but me, being broke, had to buy mine out of the vending machine from the mall.
And the wedding band is fake?
Yep. Hey, it came with free gum. Anyways, she doesn't know it's fake. The rings really mean a lot to her, but this year I finally made up for it. I'm not only getting her a ring, but I'm getting one to match. His and hers wedding bands. The ad promised that the stones are of the highest quality and of the lowest cost, but never mind that. Listen, I'm even having his and hers engraved inside of the rings. Isn't that great? His and hers, she's gonna love it.
How have you been able to afford all that? Business hasn't been that good.
I found a great deal in last week's paper.
Really?
Yeah, here, I'll show you.
You should have told me you were planning this. I have an uncle in the gemstone business.
You seem to have an uncle in every business.
I have a lot of uncles.
I think I'll stick to the newspaper. I know it's legal. There.
My goodness, I've never seen rings this cheap. Are you sure this is on the up and up? Are you sure the stones are real? After 10 years, I think she deserves a real diamond.
Are you saying this doesn't look legit?
Well, what did the stones look like? Oftentimes, fake diamonds are easy to spot.
What did they look like? I don't know. I haven't seen them yet. That's what I'm waiting for. They were supposed to be delivered this morning.
You haven't seen them yet?
Oh, Peter.
Oh dear. Was that stupid of me?
Don't get upset just yet. I'm sure they're real.
The guy on the phone sounded really nice. He doesn't seem like the kind of person that would take advantage of me.
Although, it was a 900 number.
Don't worry, Carol is going to love it.
Oh, okay. Just don't tell her about it.
Why would I do that?
And don't tell Vicky.
Don't worry about that. She hasn't paid attention to me in years.
Alright. It's just that this is the biggest surprise I've tried to plan in a long time. I don't want it ruined at the last moment.
My lips are sealed.
Oh, Pete, I just saw the surprise Carol's making you. I don't think there's a chance you could get it anything better. Steve, why can't you be that sweet? You made nothing for me but problems. Well, maybe a few babies, but that's it. What happened to the sweet guy I married? Oh, that's right. He abandoned me after the honeymoon. Carol, he's gonna love it. He's so crafty, unlike some people I know. Steve, you didn't take off your hat. What good are you to me? You're my husband and you won't even listen to me. I bet Peter listens to everything Carol says. Why did I even marry you? We'll be going.
Goodbye, Peter.
Goodbye, Steve. Goodbye, Vicky.
Congratulations, you guys. I'm so happy. Carol, if you ever need help with the present, you know where you can find me. Right next door.
Thank you.
I told you to take off the hat!
I like the hat!
No!
Wow.
Promise me we'll never get like that.
I promise.
Good. So, what are you doing out here?
Nothing. What are you doing in there?
Nothing.
Now get lost!
All right, Luke, you sound surprised.
You bought her a ring? That's so sweet!
Don't want her to know about it.
Oh, sorry. You bought her a ring? That's so sweet!
He told you? He wasn't supposed to tell you.
Don't worry, my lips are sealed. I just think it's so sweet how romantic you are. Actually, I was hoping you could help Steve out in that department.
I'll be sure to give him a few pointers.
Good! I want a new ring. The only rock Steve has ever given me is the one in his head. So how big's the stone? Pretty big, I'm assuming. You wouldn't want to let Carol down. Do you think it's all right if I bother her again?
No. She's still getting her surprise ready.
I forgot to ask if she could take the kids tomorrow.
Fine. Just don't tell her about the rain.
Oh, why won't you know me?
I do know you.
I'm sorry. I had to tell her. She wouldn't quit hitting you in my hat.
I knew I shouldn't have said anything. She's in there right now with Carol. I know she's blabbing all about the ring.
I'm so sorry.
I guess it's not your fault. I suppose Carol will still love it, but I just really wanted it to be a surprise.
Maybe she won't tell her?
Steve, that's a good one.
Maybe she won't tell her.
Thank you, Carol. This really helps out a lot, you taking the kids and all.
Who's watching them right now, Vicky?
Your mother, actually.
My mother? She never said anything about that.
It was a last-minute thing. I knew I couldn't call you because it's the anniversary. Your mother was watering the lawn, so I asked her.
Good. Anything to keep her away from here.
Peter, I asked you not to speak about my mother that way.
I'm sorry. It's just that she hates me for no reason at all. I don't smoke. I don't drink. I don't even leave the toilet seat up.
I hear that, Steve. You can learn a few things from Peter, yeah?
No, I've heard.
She doesn't hate you.
Oh, yeah? For Christmas, she bought me a ticket to South America. A one-way ticket.
You take her entirely the wrong way.
The wrong way? She tried to send me to Brazil. I said I'd bring back some coffee or something, but she laughed. The woman laughed at me. Said I wouldn't be coming back. How am I supposed to take that the wrong way?
I know she's a little unhandled sometimes, okay? But she's my mother, and I love her. And I tried to tell her what a good husband you were, and she just said, no!
Carol! I know you love your mother. And I'm sure she's a nice person when she's not trying to export me. You shouldn't be crying on our anniversary.
No.
How about this?
What?
You go into the bedroom and relax.
I can finish the surprise I had for you in there.
That sounds like a great idea.
Okay, I'm gonna do that idea. Bye, Steve.
Just go in there and relax. Vicky, did you tell her about the ring?
Why would I do a thing like that? It's a surprise.
You didn't tell her?
I'm not gonna tell someone a secret.
Oh, sure, you can keep Pete a secret, but you have to tell everyone about my kidney infection.
Well, that I had to explain.
Explain what?
You were practically living in the bathroom.
I'm sure Peta and Carol would like to get on with their anniversary.
Yes, I'm sure they would. We'll be going.
Goodbye, Vicky.
Happy anniversary.
Good luck, Steve.
Thanks.
Didn't wish them a happy anniversary, and I told you to take off the hat!
Just let me have this one thing!
No!
Fine! Alright. So where are those rings? They should have been delivered over an hour ago. I mean, when you pay good money for something, they should at least be on time. Hello? This is Peter Harris. I have an order that was supposed to be here by now. Yes, that's the one. The biggest stones you got? Perfect. I know it was a lot of money. It's just that my wife will be so happy. Yes, I'm sure she wants this. She's been waiting for this for years. I'm gonna give it to her tonight. I should have done this years ago. All right, I'm sorry. You say they're on their way? All right, thank you.
Who are you talking to?
Nobody. I was on the phone. With who?
You'll see.
I sure hope you haven't got anything extravagant planned. The hotel room alone must be costing you a fortune.
You never mind the price. You're gonna love it.
I'm sure I will.
Now get lost!
Oh, mother, it's you.
What kind of greeting is that? Where were you raised? And more importantly, where is my daughter? You've probably got her chained to the stove or something.
Oh,
you'd never give her a moment's peace.
Carol, it's for you!
Trying to pawn me off on my own daughter, I see. Well, I won't have it. I'll always be around to supervise the goings on in this house.
Tell me about it. What are you doing here this time?
Vicky told me you've smartened up and bought my daughter a decent engagement ring.
She told you?
Of course, she told me.
Figures.
So I figured I'd come over and make sure my daughter is treated right. Diamond?
Of course, diamond.
A diamond cluster, I suppose. You'd never spring for a real stone, now would you?
Carol, it's your mother!
I'll have you know, I spent a great deal of money on these rings.
Not the children's college money, I hope.
Is there any pleasing you? We don't even have children.
Yes. You will.
We don't even know if we're going to have children.
Have you been brainwashing my daughter? She was raised to be a mother, and if you can't provide that for her, I will gladly find her a new husband. Look. I want to be a grandmother. A sweet old grandmother who kisses her grandchildren goodnight. And if you can't give me that, I cannot be held responsible for my action.
Fine. Just don't tell her about the ring.
Mother, what are you doing here?
Oh, nothing. I just thought I'd stop by.
Oh, Vicky said you were taking care of her kids. How was that?
Dreadful. My old bones can't tolerate it. They're just so hard to handle.
Vicky's kids are little angels.
I was talking about Steve and Vicky. Vicky never stops yapping, and Steve, well, he is the worst husband in the world. Sorry, second worst. At least he bought Vicky an engagement ring when they were engaged.
Mother, will you please drop this ring business? You've been going on about it for 10 years.
And I'll go on for another 10 until you get your diamonds.
Mother, I've just about had it with you. I'll have you know that I am a devoted husband and your daughter loves me.
Hogwash! She was raised with higher standards than this. And do not call me mother.
How about old Sal?
You're gonna call me names, huh? Well, I have a name for you.
Okay,
all
right.
I have
one.
You just come over.
Mother, I love Peter, and if you can't accept that, I can't make you, but please let me live my life the way I want to. Let me realize that Peter is the sweetest man I've ever met. He's kind, gentle, and loving. He treats me with decency and respect. He makes me feel special. I love him dearly, and he loves me.
And I love you, Carol, but it took me 18 years to prove my love to you. What has Peter done to prove it? Nothing.
He's done plenty to prove it.
I'll believe it when I see it.
What?
Which is precisely why I'm here.
Mother, I told you not to say anything.
Let's just say the gift you'll be receiving for your anniversary will either prove to me that Peter is a loving husband or a degenerate nincompoop.
Mother, I'll have you know that Peter here, this Peter, is taking me out to a 5-star restaurant, the ballroom for dancing, and a night of romance at the Hilton.
That's it? Isn't there anything else, Peter?
Mother, you promised!
Fine. But just remember, today is the day to prove yourself a worthy husband.
Finally! Carol, will you please take your mother here into the bedroom with you?
Oh, you go ahead. I want to see what's happening.
No. Out! Both of you!
And why should I leave?
When you come out, you will see that I am a loving and devoted husband. Now get lost!
Come on, come on. Better not let me down.
All right, come on!
Hello?
Delivery for Mr. Peter Harris.
That's me. Where are they?
You want me to bring them in?
Yes, I want you to bring them in!
I'll be right back. You sign there, okay?
You want me to bring them in? Some people are so stupid.
Where is it? Let's see it.
Mother, get back in the bedroom!
It better be beautiful!
It will be dazzling! Now get lost!
I want them to say that.
Wait. What's going on here? What are these?
His and her stones. Who died?
No. There must be some sort of mistake. I didn't order gravestones.
Can we come in yet?
No, you're staying in there.
Yes, you did. It says right here. Two large stones. Engraved with his and hers. To be delivered to Mr. Peter Harris. 112 Hill Street. Now that's you, right?
Yes.
This is 112 Hill Street, isn't it?
Yes, but I wanted jewelry.
Then how come you called a gravestone supplier?
Oh, I don't know. The name of your store was called Heavenly Stones. Now you're staying in there forever! What am I supposed to do?
Don't tell me. The rings were for your wife.
Yes.
It's your anniversary, isn't it?
Yes.
And that voice over there was your mother-in-law, wasn't it? Boy, are you in trouble!
Stay back, foul beast!
Can I have your payment, please?
Where is it?
Where's what?
You know darn well what.
What are you hiding, dear?
Your anniversary present, no doubt. The ring is so ugly, he has to hide it.
The ring? Peter, my engagement ring?
Yes! No!
Are you going to pay me with cash or credit card?
Where's the ring?
You're so precious.
Just run along into the bedroom here.
Look over and show the ring!
Oh my goodness!
Are you going to pay me or what?
I ordered them.
You ordered me headstone for our anniversary.
I told you he was no good.
It was a mistake.
The one time he proved himself to me and he louses up.
Oh, who is it now?
I have to get going. Where's your payment?
Take them back. I don't want them.
I can't, sir. They're engraved.
Oh. Who's got heads?
That's me. You are under arrest!
Wait!
What? You are under arrest for what?
The murder of your wife.
What?
Purchased a couple of gravestones and were planning to give them to your wife?
I wanted to give her a ring!
Likely story.
It's true!
You can explain yourself when we get down to the station!
Take him away, officer!
Vicky, what are you doing here?
Peter tried to kill Carol.
What? What's going on here? Carol, please do something!
No, leave him alone! He's going right where he belongs!
Wait, not until he pays for the stones!
Stop. I love him! You just shut your
Mr. Police Officer, man, you there.
Peter has not tried to kill anyone. I'm not sure where you get that impression, but I am perfectly fine.
He just told her to say that.
He did not.
Probably told her to say that too.
But we got a call from the cemetery. They said that he bought some gravestones and was planning to give it to you.
Listen, I can't.
Listen,
I can't. If you stop or what I can.
Are you done yet?
All right, I can explain.
He can explain. Explain, honey.
First, take off these handcuffs.
Well.
Bye, Steve. Can you get me a newspaper over by the sofa?
Well, it wouldn't exactly call it a sofa, but like a lovely
yeah.
Done! Wait a minute now. What does the paper have to do with anything to do with anything, huh?
Look, right there, at the end. Stones for you and your loved ones at discount prices. I thought I was buying my wife a diamond ring.
On sale? What did I tell you, Carol? Cheapskate.
Mother, be quiet.
I said I was going to give it to her tonight. I was hoping to give her an engagement ring.
But you were already married.
Is it anyone romantic anymore?
No, just ask Steve.
I don't care. If you thought you were getting jewelry, you still have to pay for these.
I can't afford headstones.
I'll take them. You say these are cheap, huh?
Very cheap.
Good. I just met my mother-in-law. She's gonna dig me an early grave.
All right. Let's go outside and make a deal.
Sounds
wait,
good.
Wait, these are heavy. I need your help.
Terribly sorry if I caused any havoc.
No problem, officer.
Holy Toledo, these are heavy.
Let's just get home to the kids.
Just a minute. Carol, are you all right?
I'm a little upset.
Yo, where's upset?
For 10 years, I have tried to make you realize that Peter is not the man for you. But, you see you're not going to listen, so I give up. Vicky, you're a lucky woman. At least Steve can provide children for you. I was hoping my daughter would get something special for her anniversary, but I guess that was just too much to expect from this numbskull.
I'm still going to get Carol something for our anniversary.
Yeah, baby.
What?
No.
Carol's pregnant.
You're pregnant?
Good going, Vicky.
Carol, you're pregnant? Yes! Son! I always knew you were the perfect husband!
Honey, this is wonderful!
I was planning on telling you tonight.
Oh, I can't wait to go home and start knitting little booties. This is the best news I've heard in decades. I knew you wouldn't let me down.
Goodbye, Grandma.
Grandma? I'm gonna be a grandma! Oh, thank you, Lord!
Vicky, you've been pregnant 4 times and your mother still hates me.
Well, of course she does! She wants grandchildren, but not that badly.
Let's just go home and leave these two lovebirds alone.
All right, honey.
Honey?
I picked it up from PETA.
Let's go, sweetheart.
I'm sorry for blowing your secrets.
Oh, I think it all worked out for the best.
If you ever need anything, you know where I'll be.
Congratulations.
You know what, Steve? You're not such a bad husband, but I'd love you even more if you got me a ring for our anniversary.
All right, but when is our anniversary?
Never mind! For the last time, stop wearing the stupid hat!
Okay!
What an anniversary.
I'll say.
So we're really gonna have a baby.
Yep. That reminds me, Peter.
What are you doing?
I'm getting your anniversary present.
I'm sorry I don't have an anniversary present for you today. I promised to get you the diamonds you always wanted.
Peter, I need a ring. The baby's present enough. Here, it took me a while to find the box in there.
A wedding band?
To replace the fake one you have.
You knew?
Yes, every time we held hands, my fingers turned green.
I love you, Carol.
I love you too, Peter. We both love you. Happy anniversary. That they have to pay for what they do. Play the tune, you have to pay the piper. Now that's what my daddy always told me. Of course, he can't call him daddy anymore. Oh no, he's a parental unit. This decade stinks. I should save this for company. Where is that insurance man? Of course he's late. And I'm sure that when I tell him he's late, he'll blame his watch and then try to sue the maker. People these days, you can't trust any of them. I sure hope he's one of those flashy types. I bet he is. You probably can't even call him an insurance man either. He probably has to be a lifestyle adjuster or something stupid like that. You probably even ask me how many years young I am. So they always ask you when you're old, how many years young. Like it takes 74 years to get young. An awfully long time to wait to get young. Oh, there's the flashy creep with all of his political correctness and snappy jargon. I'll fix him, he won't get past me.
Good evening, Miss Thorndyke.
It's Mrs., I'm not afraid to say it.
Fine, I believe we have an appointment.
You're late.
Oh, yes. Terribly sorry, my watch must be running slow.
Oh, well then you'll fit right in here. Sit down.
Look at this thing. One of the best on the market. Swiss movement.
You ought to buy American.
Oh, I do. This was a gift. My car is an American brand.
Yeah, I'm impressed.
Ah, you're one of those no-nonsense types. I like that.
Oh, well then you'll be just tickled with me. What a coat.
Oh, this is my Jordan Cottrell spring and summer disco blazer.
Yeah. Well, in my day, we used to call them coats.
You like it?
It looks like an awning down on Travis. Now park it.
Okay, thank you. Is that iced tea?
Yup. Of course, I like to call it my Lipton spring and summer afternoon thirst slacker.
That's good.
Try some.
Don't mind if I do. So you say that you're married?
I was.
My husband passed away 8 years ago. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Why? It wasn't your fault.
I can see I'm gonna have to be on my toes with you.
Probably a good idea.
Do you own this house or do you rent?
Why, do you want to move in?
I wouldn't mind finding a place like this, you know. I'm so glad you called. There's plenty of other insurance agencies out there, and we're always just glad when somebody chooses us. It's a nice neighborhood.
Been in the family for years.
What?
The house. You asked about the house. It's
been in the family for years, right. I better take notes.
Are you married?
I haven't found the right woman yet.
Well, maybe it's the coat.
Yes. Mrs. Thorndyke.
The name's Simpkins. Ida Simpkins.
But I thought you said your name was Thorndyke.
I always do that until I meet someone. Never give your right name until you know who you're dealing with.
Probably a good idea. Ida Simpkins.
That's also why I called you just before you left your office.
That's right, you did call me, and you gave me the wrong address, too. Shame on you.
There's a P in there.
What?
You want the right spelling, don't you? It's Simpkins. S-I-M-P-K-I-N-S.
Right, and this house is?
It's been in the family for years.
No, the address. What's the address?
Nope, I don't know you well enough yet.
Okay, and how many years young are you?
Who writes your stuff?
What?
Don't you like the tea?
Yes, it's very good.
You haven't tried anything.
Oh. Delicious. You make it yourself?
No, I have it flown in.
Of course, I just meant there must be many different ways to make tea.
74.
You know all of them?
No, I'm 74 years old. You ass.
I remember.
Why don't you take off your coat?
It's not bothering me.
Well, it's bothering me.
Mrs. Simpkins, just why did you call me over here this evening?
I want to buy some insurance. You sell insurance, don't you?
Yes, but...
Well, then chances are if I called you over here is that I want to buy some insurance. Does that sound about right to you?
What kind of insurance?
What kind do you got?
Well, we have a variety of policies, each designed to provide you, the client, with the utmost in coverage.
I want some insurance.
I see. What sort?
Maybe you can tell me. What kind do you think I would need?
How about accidental death?
Hold on a second. There, that's nice.
Oh, you like music?
Who doesn't like music?
Some people just find it distracting.
Well, I find that it soothes my nerves.
By all means, leave it on.
If you don't like it, then just say so.
I didn't... How about hospitalization?
What are you gonna do to me?
No, the policy! How about the hospitalization policy?
No need to shout. I'm only 74 years young, you know. Why don't you take off your coat?
Sure, fine.
Listen, let me tell you why I called you over here this evening.
Hurry, I'm losing interest.
Say, you've got a wit about you. I like that.
Thank you. So, just why did you call me over here?
Too much violence going on in the neighborhood. Why'd you hear about that young couple that got run over last night?
Yes. Yes, I did. Tragic.
Well, that was only a couple blocks over from here.
Was it?
Got me to thinking.
We are living in perilous times, Mrs. Thorne. Simpkins, with a P.
Yes, we are.
Can't be too careful.
Sure you can.
I just meant... Why don't you talk now?
The whole world is going to hell in a wheelbarrow. The neighborhood is getting run down. People are moving away. The houses on both sides of me are empty now.
So you feel alone here, vulnerable?
Thought you were going to let me talk.
Sorry, I lost my place.
Oh, I have my diversions. Lots of things to keep me busy. It's not like I can't do anything for myself.
I have a lovely garden out back.
Yes.
Can I?
Shoot.
Do you want hospitalization?
You're not listening to me, are you?
Sure I was. I just thought since I was over here, we could do a little business.
I was talking about my garden.
Right. When was your last physical?
About 8 years ago. Now, it's a lovely garden in the spring. Of course, right now, it's nothing but weeds.
Do you have any pre-existing diseases?
No, just weeds.
Do you suffer from anything?
Have you ever heard of the vapors?
No.
How about brain fever?
No.
What about the epizootic?
Doesn't ring a bell.
Then I'm fine.
No pre-existing.
What was that you were saying earlier about the, accidental something?
Oh, accidental death?
Yeah. Maybe that'll be good.
Fine. Do you have any children?
This is my policy. Let them get their own.
Oh. I thought since you mentioned that your husband had passed away that you'd want your children to be your beneficiaries.
Nope. No need.
Well, if you get an accidental death policy, then you have to have beneficiaries.
How come?
For one thing, no one would get the benefits.
Oh, so then you mean there'd be no point in me dying?
Can you sit down?
Here, that chair might be more comfortable for you.
Thank you.
Take that young couple that got run over last night. Run down in the prime of life. I wonder if they weren't hurt.
Can we forget about them for a minute?
Oh, sure. Just forget about what's going on all around us. Somebody ought to pay for that, don't you think?
I'm sure they will.
Just like my Humphrey.
Humphrey?
My late husband.
What do you mean?
It's the court system in this country.
Ma'am?
Oh, sure, they might catch the man who ran that couple over, and they might even arrest him. But he'll get off you, mark my words.
Late husband named Humphrey.
You look a little dry.
How did he die?
Who?
Humphrey.
There's no need in dragging all of that back up again.
It's just for my records.
1709 Commerce.
What?
That's this address.
Like pulling teeth.
Yeah, and they're all mine, too.
Why don't you want to talk about your husband?
Because he's just like you. Never listened to me.
Just like...
But he paid the piper in the end.
Paid the piper?
It's sort of an old saying. Certainly applied to Humphrey.
Yeah, well, I think that I have all that I need here.
Where are you going?
I have to speak with my superiors. I don't even know if you're in my territory.
We're in the same room, for crying out loud.
I have a lot of other calls to make.
You told me I was your last one of the evening, Mr. Hanover.
Well, you're just not being very honest with me, that's all.
I'm telling you everything that you want to know.
Okay. All right. Fine. How did your husband die?
A heart attack.
Fine.
Yeah, at least that's what the coroner said.
That's it. I'm out of here.
Just like that?
Just like that.
You don't want to know anything else?
I told you I have to speak with my superiors.
You can't just write me up here.
I have to go through channels.
I'd like $100,000 policy.
Well, I'm sure you won't be sorry. We have a wide range of coverage, and I'm sure with your cooperation, we'll just whip right through it.
I thought that would get your attention.
$100,000 policy.
Yes. Don't you want to know anything else about Humphrey?
Was he insured with us?
No.
That's his problem. Hospitalization?
Yes, I suppose so.
Would you also like our limited hospital / surgery policy?
I suppose. / that'll be fine.
For $100,000.
That's right.
This will also provide you with $100 a day during an in-hospital stay.
Whatever you say.
Now, do you or do you not have any children?
Oh, yes. Now I suppose you could say I do. Or I did.
Oh?
Yes.
They are also no longer with us.
That's right.
I'm so sorry.
Are you? Are you really?
Well, of course, who wouldn't be?
What about that man who ran down that couple?
He
didn't seem to care about what he'd done.
Why do you keep bringing that up?
Just trying to prove a point.
Can we stick to the subject?
I am.
No, you don't understand.
No, you don't understand. You see, the police have been asking a lot of questions recently.
That makes sense. That's their job.
Well, something like that would rattle a person.
I can understand how it might.
Yes, and how agitated you've gotten.
It's been a long day.
Yes, it has. But you should have been here.
What do you mean by that.
The police came knocking on my door asking me where I was at such and such time or what I was doing. Who can remember a thing like that?
It was just last night, right?
Yes.
I can see their point. Strike while the iron is hot.
Well, what about you?
What about me?
Where were you at 9 o'clock last night?
I don't see what that has to do with anything.
Just to give you the idea. $100,000.
Okay. Now what?
Mr. Hanover, where were you at 9 o'clock last night?
Last night, I was working late in the office.
Till 9 o'clock?
Had a lot of forms to fill out.
Do you have any witnesses?
What?
Is there anybody else in the office who can corroborate your testimony?
Say, you're good at this.
I watch a lot of Matlock. Now, is there anybody else in the office?
Okay. The cleaning woman.
Her name?
I don't know her name.
But she can testify to where you were.
I suppose so.
Suppose so?
Mrs. Simpkins, what are you doing?
Do you drink, sir?
Do I? I may have a beer or two, just unwind.
But you don't drink heavily?
No. None as a rule.
Well, then have some more tea.
I don't want any more tea.
$100,000.
Fine, give me. There, are you happy?
Yes, very.
Well, I can see how all of that would unnerve you.
You're starting to sweat a little yourself.
Oh, am I? Runs in the family. My dad could work up a sweat just bending over.
Something caught in your throat?
No, it's just a little hot in here.
Maybe if you moved around a bit.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe if I just got up and. Whoa, my head.
It's probably the heat. I do keep it pretty hot in here. That's what happens when you get young like me.
Right. 74.
Right? 74 years old. I'm old. Will you admit that?
Whatever you want.
People these days, they don't think much about old people. It scares them.
What?
Old age. I think it'll never happen to them. Have you ever thought about it?
I'm in the insurance game. We deal with old people all the time.
Yes, but have you ever thought about it? About it happening to you?
I'm usually too busy. Can you open up a window or something?
Well, if I were you, I think right now would be a very good time to start thinking about it.
Old age? Now?
Yes, your old age.
Why right now?
Marvin, what is this? You don't have one.
What?
Doesn't it?
I don't know what you're talking about. What is happening? My head.
People are like that all over. They don't want to die old, but they're too scared to die young. Frying pan and fire type thing, I guess. It's an old saying. You've probably never heard of it.
Must have a fever. Got a bug or something. Maybe a little tea will.
Oh, help yourself.
Just what I need right now.
Oh yes, it's just what you need right now.
What do you mean by that?
Just relax for a little bit.
Maybe if I just get up.
Lean back a minute, and it'll all be over soon.
All be over?
Just relax for a minute.
You didn't drink any of this. Mrs. Simpkins, you put something in the tea!
Oh, you mean my Lipton's spring and summer afternoon thirst slaker?
What have you done?
I figured you would be thirsty, like you were last night.
Last night? But no, nobody was.
Nobody was what? Nobody was around during the accident.
You know?
Oh, of course I know. You see, I was out in the neighborhood around 9 o'clock last night.
With the police, you said they questioned you.
And I answered them, oh, so sorry. Thank you, Mrs. Simpkins, they said. We're so sorry that you didn't see or hear anything, they said. I bet that they felt sorry for me.
Mrs. Simpkins, please.
Now, Mr. Hanover, what would you give for your old age? What would you give for it right now? Say, $100,000?
You want me to hand you that much money?
No, I don't want your money.
Then, what do you want from me?
A little thing you might like to call retribution.
Retribution?
I like to call it revenge. It makes more sense that way.
You'll never get away with it.
You asked about my children. Remember? Earlier?
I remember you. The couple! One of them is your...
Now, just relax a bit and it'll all be over soon. And, once it's all over, I have a lovely place for you out back. It's so quiet now. Especially with nobody left in the neighborhood to disturb you. My garden, remember? I told you about it.
You're
your children. I didn't see them. Please, please believe me. I was turning the corner when I didn't...
You didn't see much of anything now, did you?
I had too much to drink.
Oh, but that can't be. Because I thought you said you weren't much of a drinker. But that was a lie now, wasn't it?
Yes, yes, please, please call someone. I'm sorry.
Thirst is what caused that accident. And I guess you could say thirst is what put you where you are right now. See? Retribution.
Don't never get away with it. People, my people know where I am.
Oh, I'm afraid they don't. Remember, I gave you the wrong name and address, and I called you just before you left your office.
Then maybe someone here, someone in the neighborhood.
I told you, there's nobody left in the houses on either side of me. Ma, you really should have taken notes.
Mrs. Thorndike!
It's Simpkins with a P.
Please, don't do this! I'm...
Oh, you're sorry? I must admit, I first thought about turning you in, but what would that accomplish?
I'll never drink again.
Oh, that's what they all say now, don't they?
No, don't.
And since it's your first offense, they'll let you off easy. I've seen it 1,000 times.
I'll take you.
My, aren't you a frisky one?
Please, give me something.
Now you asked about my children, remember?
That's right. The police, they'll trace you to this. You're one of the couple's mothers, but... No, you can't be. You're too
old. Is that what you're trying to say?
Grandmother, then. One of their grandmothers. They'll get you.
No, I'm afraid they won't. You see, I don't even know who that couple was.
What?
Never even met them as far as I know. No relation to them at all.
Then why?
There are other kinds of children.
Other kinds?
Mr. Hanover, you didn't just murder 2 people last night. Remember?
What?
You also murdered my Pandora. My sweet Pandora!
You're kidding me! Nothing but a stinky
cat. Nothing like a glass of tea to fix things in the evening. And now you don't have to worry about your old age anymore. Oh, I should have asked. Mr. Hanover, do you have any insurance?
Ghost of your father. but my dad's not dead.
Sure I am!
No, I'm pretty sure that's something I would know, something Mom might have mentioned during breakfast.
It's part of me inside that's dead.
What killed
you? You did!
Well, you and your brother. Mostly your brother.
How did...
Disappointment! Disappointment killed me inside, and I need you to avenge my death.
Avenge your death? By disappointment?
Yes.
How do I do that?
What are you, stupid?
Yeah, I am stupid. It's called being 17.
See, this is partly what killed me inside. Just do what I ask.
Why can't Lars do it?
Your brother? No, he's most of the disappointment.
No, it's up to you!
But what am I supposed to-
Avenge my death!
How do I do-
No!
Why do you keep saying that?
Please, I'm begging you, for once in your life, just do something I ask!
How do I know you're even real? How do I know you're not like a dream or an anxiety attack? I'm under a lot of pressure, you know, with graduation in 3 weeks and all.
No!
What does that mean?
No! Stop!
How do you even die of disappointment?
At least he left the restaurant. Probably didn't tip, though. Nope, the dead are lousy tippers.
So, what should I do?
Well, if I were you,
I'd study hard.
Are you talking to me?
If I were you, I'd study hard, buckle down, get my rear in gear as your guidance counselor. I am obliged to tell you that there are 3 weeks left in the semester and you are flunking 3 of your classes. One of them, national government, is a requirement to graduate.
I didn't realize things were so dire.
You didn't? What, why is that? Are you distracted? Are you having trouble at home?
Well, my parents are fighting right now, I think. My dad doesn't really call much, but I guess things are all right.
Then you need to get it together! You gotta buckle down and get it together fast if you're going to graduate on time. You need to retake tests, come in for extra help, make up those zeros, in other words, put the pedal to the metal! You gotta get it together quickly if you are going to graduate on time.
Oh, whoa, this is overwhelming. You think I can do it?
Of course you can! You have to. Your future is at stake. You gotta pull up your britches and... Oh. Who am I kidding? You don't stand a chance. Well, not much of one.
Hey, you're a guidance counselor. Are you allowed to say that?
Look, Pete. I don't know you very well, but your record speaks for itself.
My record?
You flunk classes more often than not. You're often in trouble. You've shown no direction at all, whatsoever.
What are you saying?
Do you really think you can do it? Do you really think you can make up all those zeros? Do you think Miss Bergeron is just gonna slide you through national government? Can you really make up all those credits in just 3 weeks?
So what should I do?
If I were you, I'd give up.
You mean quit school?
Sure! Stop wasting time! Get out there, earn a paycheck, start contributing to society for once.
But I'd be a high school dropout. Where'd I even get a job?
What about that concrete lawn ornament factory? I hear they're expanding.
Concrete lawn ornaments?
Sure! Bird baths. Swans.
Gnomes!
Gnomes, I think. Could be your future.
Did you hear something?
I didn't hear anything. Look, just think about what I said. That's what I would do.
Quit school? That would really kill my dad.
Doesn't anyone around here deep?
Dolores, my guidance counselor is telling me I should quit school. What would you do?
Then if I were you,
I'd stand at attention, look straight ahead on sight, and sign on this dotted line.
Wait, what if I'm looking straight ahead?
Did I give you permission to speak?
Eyes straight ahead! Stand straight! Chin up! If I were you, I wouldn't be giving any lip to the representative of the United States Army!
The Army? Seriously?
Are you kidding me, son? Are you in any position to mouth off?
Probably not.
There is no probably in the United States Army, son! There is only yes, sir, and no, sir!
But I'm not in the Army.
Are you kidding me, son? Have you seen your grades? Have you seen your options?
I mean, I know things are grim.
There is no grim in the United States Army, son! Your future is bright in the service! You would be serving your country! Is there anything grim about serving your country?
I don't think I better say anything otherwise.
Do you know what your problem is? You have an attitude, and do you know what we do with attitudes? We crush them. We crush them under the hot Iraqi sun. We freeze them in the Bosnian winters. We bury them in the tunnels of the Afghan mountains, and we will make a man out of you, a man who is proud to serve his country. If I were you, I wouldn't waste any time thinking it over. Thinking it over is for weak men. Thinking it over is for the spineless pinkos who let this country get overrun by communists and terrorists. Thinking it over is for the un-American. Thinking it over is for... Hey, that guy looks like Osama bin Laden. You there, stop!
A thief from the government, I don't even know why I bothered to look.
Wait, I don't know, Dolores, the military? I mean, I know I'm not the best student, but I still thought I might go to college. You know, me and my girlfriend were talking about going to the same college, maybe community college, and we could...
Your girlfriend's here!
What?
Hello!
Why were you? I break up with me!
Oh.
What?
Studies show that post-high school relationships rarely last a year past graduation.
What study?
And when a couple is separated by 500 miles or more, the odds are really bad.
500 miles? Where are you going?
To college, silly, to Cornell.
Cornell? Isn't that like a really good school?
It is a very good school. Why do you think I've been studying so hard lately?
I don't know, just thought maybe it was your way of avoiding me here.
Why would I hurt you? I love you.
So we're not breaking up.
Of course we are. What's the point? I'm going off to college in 3 months.
So that's what I'll do. I'll go to Cornell with you.
I've seen your grades. Are you going to graduate?
Yes! Of course! Probably! There's a chance.
Besides, were you talking about going to like Montana with Jordan or something?
I don't know. Nothing's definite.
Look, Pete, it's been fun, but...
Are we really breaking up?
If I were you, that's what I'd do. Make a clean break. Start fresh. Don't waste your time.
Wow.
I'm sorry, Pete.
That is tough.
You heard all that?
I hear everything that goes on in here. Sometimes too much.
So what should I do?
Well, if I were you.
If I were you, I'd learn all the names of the presidents, beginning with Washington and ending with Trump. And the preamble to the Constitution and the National Anthem.
Why?
Why? Why, you ask? Well, I'll tell you why. Out of respect for this great country, that's why. Out of respect for this great nation called the United States of America. Out of respect for the great men who have led this country of ours. And out of respect for the great American education system, which gives you the privilege, that's right, the privilege, to learn the names of the presidents backwards and forwards. And if I had it my way, if my congressman will ever answer my letters, out of respect to the 28th Amendment, which when ratified, will read, all high school students will learn the name and the order of the presidents, as well as the preamble to the Constitution, the National Anthem, the Bill of Rights, and Nixon's resignation speech.
You already require all of those things, except the Nixon thing. It's why I'm not gonna graduate.
All the more reason to learn them. Plus, there's still time. So if I were you, I'd start studying now. Name the president's dog.
Washington? Lincoln?
No. Have you learned nothing?
If I were you, I'd use mnemonics to learn the names of the presidents. For instance, you erroneously stated that Lincoln was the second president.
He's not.
No, he's not. He's the 16th president. But just to remember this, if you take the digits of the number 16, 1 and 6, and reverse them, 6 and 1, and take the difference of those two, you get...
Five.
And who's on the $5 bill? Lincoln! See, you'll never forget.
Wait, what if I think of a nickel? Isn't that Jefferson?
If I were you, I'd take the first letters of the last names of the first 10 presidents. Washington, Adams, Jefferson, Madison, Monroe, John Quincy Adams, Jackson, Van Buren, Harrison, and Tyler, and take those letters, wadge-madge-ba-butta, and put them into a sentence to help you remember. Like this. Will a Japanese maple multiply? After juvenile vampires bite. Wadge madge. You cut off the first 10 presidents like it was nothing, and you can't read from where to go.
Wait, shouldn't there be a Q in there somewhere?
What?
John Quincy Adams.
Let's try the preamble. I find it's easiest if you memorize it by doing hand motions like this. Follow me. We, the people, in order to form a more perfect established justice.
I think this is the way we learned it when I was in fifth grade.
Then why don't you know it now? Let's try the national anthem. I find it's easiest if you put the words into a tune. You see how well that worked out for you. I can't work like this. If I were you, I'd seriously consider a career in the service industry. If I were you, I'd... Well, I shouldn't say this.
What, Mom?
If I were you, I'd... Well, your father!
He says he's dead.
He's dead to me. Do you know what he did?
Wanna know?
He ran over my lawn gnome.
Which one? You got lots of gnomes.
That's the thing. All those gnomes? I hate them.
What? I thought you loved your gnomes.
I love the one gnome. Mr. Mordecai. The one your father hit with a riding lawnmower. Do you know where that gnome came from?
Didn't it used to be in Grandma's yard?
It did. My mother's gnome. And Mr. Mordecai was one of a kind, very rare, never seen anything like it. It used to make me think of Mom every time I saw it. And your father hit him with the lawnmower! How could that happen?
Well, the throttle was all messed up. He used to just surge suddenly. He probably just lost control. But I fixed it.
You're pretty good with that kind of thing.
So, what do you have against the rest of the gnomes?
Your father won't even say he's sorry. He won't even admit he did it. He blames Lars. Like Lars has ever mowed the lawn. And now he keeps buying me new gnomes. Like that'll make up for it. He buys two or three a week.
And?
If I were you, I'd make the gnomes disappear.
Disappear? Like how?
I don't know. Load them into the station wagon. Make it look like an outside job. Then take them far, far away.
Like where?
I don't know. Do I have to tell you everything? Really, really far away. Like Montana or something.
Montana? I've always wanted to go to Montana.
Really? I've never heard you mention that before.
It's just a dream.
Well, if I were you, I'd help your mother out. Steal the stupid gnomes. Maybe your father will get the hints. $5 for a cup of coffee? I don't think so.
Well, what am I supposed to do? My dad wants me to avenge his death, and my mom wants revenge on my dad for running over a gnome. Dolores, what would you do if you were me?
Then if I were you.
No!
No!
What are you doing? Why are you wearing that sheet over here?
I'm a ghost!
You're not a ghost?
Sure I am! I keep telling you! I'm tired of disappointment! Choose to walk the other till my soul is redeemed!
Yeah, you said that earlier.
Hey, did you talk to your mother?
Yeah, she says you ran over Mr. Mordecai.
Who?
Grandma's gnome. You ran him over with the riding lawnmower.
Right. I was hoping she'd think Lars did that.
Are you kidding? I don't think Lars even knows to get the lawnmower.
I panicked. What could I do?
Well, why are you even mowing the lawn in the first place? I told you I had to work on the throttle.
You've been mowing a lot of lawns. I thought I'd help out.
Dad.
Is Mom really mad?
She doesn't like all the gnomes you keep buying her, and she says you're dead to her.
I am dead. Dream to walk.
Yeah. Avenge your disappointment. You have any idea how I'm even supposed to do that?
Are you kidding me? I'm a ghost. It's a miracle you're able to communicate with me at all. And I know the secrets of the netherworld?
Well, yeah, because...
No!
Dad, take off that sheet.
No!
Dad?
No.
Dad, come back here.
No.
Why do you keep saying that?
No.
What does that even mean? Why don't you tell me what you're trying to say?
Wait a minute.
Dad, I think I got it! Dad!
Oh, where'd he go? If I were you, little drogue, I'd go into professional skateboarding.
Professional skateboarding?
Totally, dude. I've been skating professionally for like a year now, and I'm telling you, man, I'm living the dream.
So
the dream, I tell you, man.
So you can really make money off of skateboarding?
Totally, dude. Not just like any old money. I'm talking like big money. Like last year, I made almost $200.
And who pays you this money?
People who watch me skate, man. I go down to Hyde Park where all the tourist dudes hang out, and I put out a box to collect money.
And then they just throw money in the box.
Totally, dude. Not just like pennies and nickels, too. Big money. I'm talking like quarters. And sometimes, if you're really lucky, they'll even throw in a Sacagawea dollar. Which is so totally awesome because Sacagawea is like the coolest name there is. Come on, dude, say it.
Sacagawea. Sacagawea.
Totally tubular, man.
You can really live off $200 a year?
Totally, dude. I'm telling you, I got a great place and I eat all I want.
You live in Mom and Dad's basement.
It's not a basement, little bro. It's a basement apartment.
That place doesn't even have its own door.
It so does too, man. My own private entrance.
Does where?
Right behind their water heater. There's a small opening, and if you crawl through that and belly crawl under the house, there's a small door that goes out by the hose in the backyard.
The door is like 2 feet high tops.
Which is so totally awesome, dude, because it's like a little hobbit door. Sometimes I pretend to share this space with Mom's garden gnome. It's so totally awesome. Just like my skateboarding career. That's what I would do.
Professional skateboarding?
That's what I would do if I were you. Alright, just get past these rugs.
Your brother just like fell over there.
Pete! Jordan! Dribbling! Yeah!
Dribbling! Oh.
360! Oh! Yeah!
Okay.
You know it. Oh! 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 Damn!
We almost made it that time!
Pete! You know I have sensitive thoughts! Seriously though, if I were you, I'd go to phone tech school. You like the sweatshirt? I made it myself.
Yeah.
Hey, sorry about your thigh.
Wait, so Votech school, weren't we planning to go down to Montana, do some mountain climbing and skiing?
Yeah, we talked about that, but you gotta think about getting trained too. Votech school, my boy.
Okay, that doesn't sound too bad, but what reason to study?
You'd study to be a septic tank technician.
What?
You know what a septic tank is, right?
Yeah.
Well, let's just say no one wants to do anything technical with a septic
tank. Wait, you want to spend the rest of your life in a septic tank?
It's a job, dude, and a good paying one at that. By the end of the year, I'll be raking in the big bucks while all of our other classmates will be sitting in law school eating ramen noodles.
Yeah, septic tanks.
There are other Votech classes, too. If I were you, I'd go there.
So... no, Montana then?
Septic classes start the week after graduation. If I were you, I'd go there with me instead of Montana.
Bye, Pete.
Bye. Well, I guess I messed up.
With what?
Apparently, we're not supposed to tell kids to quit school. Goes against our mission statement or something like that. Hey, you beauteous bearer of the black bean liquid, could you, Thank you.
Wait, so now you're telling me I should stay in school?
Yeah. Look, I'm supposed to help you find your career path or whatever.
So, what do you suggest?
What?
What would you do if you were me?
How am I supposed to know that? What makes me qualified on what's best for kids? 6 years of college?
So?
I don't know. Stay in school, go to college, learn a trade, join the army, make someone's day, perform random acts of kindness, don't do drugs,
wait, you're not making any sense.
Life is just one cliche after another.
So what should I do?
How am I supposed to know that? Look, do I even know you? I meet with you once or twice a year for 5 minutes. I can tell you your standardized test scores, your GPA, the drugs you've been prescribed to take, your ethnicity, but I don't know what you really want.
So, you can't help me then?
Oh, I'll help you. It's my job. Once upon a time, it was my passion. What happened?
Me?
Wait, don't answer that. Look, business, do you have anything for me to go on? Any dreams?
Oh, well, my friend Jordan and I, we were planning to go down to Montana, do some mountain climbing and some skiing, but I guess that just kind of fell through.
Montana?
Yeah.
Huh.
What, you got something?
No, seriously? That's all you got for me? Climb mountains in Montana? That's not a lot for me to go on. You know, if I were you, I'd...
Yeah?
Nope, still got nothing. Come back tomorrow.
And you'll have a plan.
I seriously doubt it. I'm just going through the motions by this point. I'm supposed to meet with every senior 3 times before the end of the school year, and usually I'm done by November, so...
Now you're sounding like my principal.
That sounds like a ghost. I'm out of here.
It's not a ghost. It's only my dad. He just thinks he's a ghost.
Oddly enough, that sounds like reason enough for me to leave.
No! Yeah!
What is it, Dad? What ghostly message from beyond do you have for me this time? Still need me to avenge your death?
I need you to mow the lawn! I do myself, but I'm a ghost. Plus, I wrecked the riding mower.
Yeah, sure, Dad, no problem.
No problem, no arguing, no, I don't have time, I'm tired, I'll do it later.
That's Lars, I never mind mowing.
That's true, I never complain about mowing.
So, need me to change the oil, or maybe sharpen the blade, or?
Yeah, sure. You know what I really need done is that brush out back. And that tree stump, but the chainsaw's broken.
No, it's not.
It's not?
I fixed it.
You fixed it?
Yeah, last week. I took it apart, put a new spark plug in it, put it back together, it works great now.
You're always good with that kind of thing.
I guess. It's easy.
You're like an idiot savant with small engines.
Thanks. Just call me an idiot.
You need to watch the haunted spectrum or something. It's a ghost thing.
Okay.
Thanks for mowing the lawn.
Yeah, sure, Dad. No problem.
And don't forget to avenge my death.
Oh. He'd forget that one. Still don't know what that means. Lawns I can mow. I mow lawns all the time, but avenge a death? Dolores, what would you do if you were me?
Well, if I were you...
If I were you, I would think about taking advanced small engines. Put your hands on.
What?
Advanced small engines. With beginning small engines, didn't you?
Yeah, when I was a sophomore.
Well, now you take the advanced class.
When do I do that?
Next year would make no sense. You might have to back.
I can't. I'm a graduating senior.
Really? Because that's not what I heard.
Yeah, well, even so, I'm not coming back next year.
That's a shame. It would have been nice to have you in advanced small engines.
Well, when I was in your class, you always acted like you hated me.
That's not true.
You would always yell at me.
Well, you would never listen.
And you poured water on my head.
Because you were always falling asleep.
You put duct tape over my mouth.
You wouldn't stop talking.
So why do you want me in your class?
Because you have a knack for small engines. I barely had to explain things to you, and you just got it. You were always 2, even 3 lessons ahead of everybody else. For the final, everybody had to rebuild one lawnmower. You rebuilt 3. Needless to say, 2 of those are for your friends so that they didn't have to do it, but that's not the point.
It was easy.
That's why you should have taken the advanced class.
But you always hated it. Okay, so I was a punk in your class.
And I would have straightened you out at some point. If I were you, I would still think about taking advanced small engines.
Well, it's too late now.
It is never too late, son.
What do you mean it's never too late? Oh man, am I really flunking high school? Am I gonna have to come back next year? How am I gonna relive live the shame of repeating my senior year? Dolores, what would you do if you were me?
If I were you,
I'd march right on down to Megamart, go to the service desk and get yourself an application.
What would I do at Megamart?
Do what I did. You gather cards in the parking lot.
Talk to me.
Boring? Nephew, you haven't lived until you've pushed a train of 50 shopping carts down an icy parking lot. You haven't felt life until you've chased a runaway shopping cart down the downhill side of the parking lot. I've experienced a train rush. Until some soccer mom backs into you with her SUV, crushing your pelvis. You've
kidding me? Mara wants that job.
Mega Mart doesn't care about a high school education. Mega Mart only cares about loyal workers who dedicate their lives to the company.
You got run over in the parking lot.
True. But even though I was hospitalized for 30 days, Mega Mart awarded my loyalty and kept my job waiting.
So, now you're still pushing carts?
Heavens no. My hip doesn't move so well now. How I do miss salsa class. But they gave me the next best job in the business.
Which is?
Greeter. Every time someone walks through the doors of Mega Mart, who is the first face they see? Me! Welcome to Mega Mart! Welcome to Mega Mart! How may I help you? Welcome to Mega Mart! Would you like a smiley face sticker, little girl? Welcome to Mega Mart! Is that a return, sir? You must put this orange tape on there. Welcome to Mega Mart! I'm sorry, sir, but you must wear a shirt and shoes in the store all the time.
Wait, I don't know about this, Shelby.
Well, if I were you, I wouldn't bother finishing high school. I never did! Welcome to Mega Mart! Welcome to Mega Mart! I'm sorry, sir, but the scooter carts are only for the elderly and pregnant! I wish I loved my job like she does.
Oh, and if I were you, I'd bring down all the laundry from your room, young man.
I already did that.
You did? Why am I missing a sheet?
Dad has it.
Once.
He's wearing it. It's a part of his ghost thing.
Oh, for crying out loud, what is his problem?
He says disappointment killed him.
He wants to talk about disappointment? Talk about a husband who destroys a family heirloom and blames it on his sons.
Come on. I think it really bothers him. He's going, no.
Well, it should bother him. I hope it bothers him a lot.
So, you can forgive him?
No, I can't forgive him. He destroyed Mr. Mordecai and denied the whole thing. Let him suffer in eternity.
What if I can fix it?
Fix Mr. Mordecai or fix the relationship?
I don't know. Both.
I threw the rest of the gnome in the trash. As for your father, I wish I could do the same.
Come on, I think he's really sorry.
Then he can tell me that. And he can bring back my sheet. And he can buy me 1,000 gnomes, but he cannot replace Mr. Mordecai.
If I were you, I'd perform an exorcism!
There's some sort of spirit living in our backyard, and I need you to get rid of it! You mean like a ghost?
Oh! I am the only ghost around here.
And there's only room for one supernatural entity on our lot. So get rid of it! So what exactly is this spirit?
It lives in the old tree stump out back. It has this spooky face that sticks out of the stump and stares at you like this. It freaks me out.
Wait, in the old tree stump out back?
Yeah. Get a priest, burn some incense or something.
Does the spirit look like a wizard?
A wizard?
Yeah, like an old wizard with long white hair and a beard.
As a matter of fact, it does. How did you know?
I made that guy.
What?
I carved him in the tree stump.
What are you talking about?
Well, last week I was clearing brush for you, remember? And I got bored, so I took the chainsaw and carved the wizard dude in the tree stump.
You really did that?
Yeah, but if you don't like it...
No. I like it. I mean, now that I know it's not some crazy tree sprite. You really did that because it's, like, really good.
Thanks.
I never knew you had that kind of talent.
It was nothing.
It was something. It was really something.
At least you didn't do that creepy ghost cry thing. No, that one.
Yeah, he didn't, did he? So, what would you do if you were me?
Well, if I were you,
I'd come. Sit down. Pay your friendly guidance counselor a visit.
You want to meet with me again?
I have to, remember?
Oh, yeah, all the seniors 3 times?
Right. Anyway, I got to looking at some Montana schools.
Why?
Didn't you say you wanted to go to school in Montana?
Hey, you remember that?
Yeah, I made a note. Turns out there are plenty of schools in Montana.
I don't really know if I'm cut out for college.
I thought of that. So, I got to looking at your GPA and your test scores.
Not pretty, huh?
No. But grades aren't everything. You know, your vocational test scores are actually pretty interesting.
How so?
Well, don't get me wrong, you're not likely to be a doctor or a lawyer.
Yeah, I could have told you that without a test.
But you're very mechanical.
Yeah?
And artistic.
Okay.
Interesting combination. And you seem like a hard worker.
You can tell that from a test?
No, but I've seen you all around town mowing lawns. You know, you mowed my neighbor's lawn, all 2 acres of it.
Oh, the Randalls.
Mm-hmm. I watched you take apart their weed whacker and then put it back together again.
Well, the pull cord was messed up. I had to put in a new one.
Huh. And according to this, Ms. Bomber says you have, and I quote, a good sense of mechanical sensibility with which to repair small engines. And then Ms. Marley, the art teacher, said you have, and I quote, an artistic soul.
Wait, talk to who's about me?
I'm just trying to find something for you.
I thought you hated your job.
I get weary from time to time. But every now and again, I find a diamond in the rough that makes it worthwhile.
I'm a diamond in the rough.
I never said that.
But you just said.
Oh, look it. Here, take all these pamphlets.
What are they?
Every school you could possibly think of in Montana. No, if I were you, I'd take a look through those, see if any of them strike a chord.
I thought you said I wasn't going to graduate.
I looked into that too. Turns out you almost have enough credits. National government is the only class you have to pass.
Yeah, well, Ms. Bergeron is insane. You won't believe all the stuff she has us memorize.
She's insane. But she is the only thing standing in between you and a high school diploma.
Well, there's no way I'm going to catch up in 3 weeks. I'm just way too far behind in that class.
You're right. There is no possible way for you to make up all those credits in just 3 weeks.
And your point is?
Miss Bergeron teaches summer school.
Summer school?
William, that's listen! You are the student, and I am the adult, and I am talking to you, and you are the student, and you will listen. Capiche?
Capiche.
As I was saying, Miss Bergeron teaches summer school, and she thought if you worked hard, really hard, you could probably finish 1 to 2 weeks into the summer. She even let you pass conditionally so you could walk at graduation.
Whoa, she really do that for me?
She's insane, but she's not an ogre.
2 weeks of summer school? All right. So, you're not going to suggest one of these?
You know, Pete, I can pluck the diamond out of the rough, but I can't polish it.
That sounds really weird.
I've been a guidance counselor a very long time. I'm just gonna go now.
Man, this is a lot of stuff to go through. A lot of stuff to read. How am I gonna get through all of this? How am I even gonna make a decision?
If I were you, I'd take a deep breath.
Yeah. Miss Marley?
In with the good air. And out with the bad. Toxins, the negativity.
Wait, what's with all the candles?
Aromatherapy.
Oh.
down.
So what are we doing?
I'm seeking my artistic self. Would you care to seek your artistic self?
I don't know what that means.
You're a very creative soul, Pete. I can see that in my class.
Can?
Most students make copies. I show them what to make. A pot, a painting, a papier-mâché, and they copy it. They're nothing but Xerox machines.
And that's bad.
Not if you want a grade. You, however, are not in search of a grade. You are in search of your artistic soul.
Hey, are you allowed to be saying this? Sounds kind of religious.
8 to 3, I teach primary colors. Off the clock, I help students like you find their
artistic
soul.
Yeah, you said that already.
Smell this candle. What does it make you think of?
Forest.
What kind of forest?
A forest with trees.
Come on, Pete, you're an artist. You can do better than that. Close your eyes.
You know, it's really weird to have a teacher talk to me like this.
Pete, I'm an art teacher. I'm allowed.
Now,
close your eyes, take a deep breath, in with the good air. Tell me, what do you smell?
I smell forest.
Yes.
An old forest. A forest thick with trees. A forest that's never been harvested. And the trees are centuries old.
Great, this is great. Okay, now take another breath, clear your mind. What do you see?
Darkness.
Go deeper.
Darkness in the forest?
Going.
And out of the forest. Out of the forest.
Out of the forest comes what, Pete?
No.
No.
A what?
A gnome. You know, like a short, bearded gnome.
A gnome?
Yeah.
Wow. What do you think that means?
I don't know. You're the spiritual guide.
I can only help you with so much. It's like the primary colors. I can teach you red, yellow, and blue, but I cannot help you paint the Mona Lisa.
You're all speaking in riddles lately.
What?
I don't know. I'm just trying to figure out what I'm going to do with my life. I don't know how to make sense of a gnome in the forest.
Well, let me try to help you. It's the least I could do. You were always one of my favorite students.
But I got a D in your
class. Let's try another candle. I'm getting something.
What is it?
It's a message.
A message from who?
No.
From the no. Do you want my help or not?
Okay, sorry, go on.
Yes? I understand.
So, what did he say?
He said, any chainsaw can cut, but your chainsaw can heal.
Any chainsaw can cut, but your chainsaw can heal?
Right.
What the heck am I supposed to do with that?
I don't know. Kind of sounds like a bunch of gibberish to me. But maybe...
Hey! You can't burn candles in my cafe! You're covering up the precious smell of the grease! Now get the very stick to get out of here, go! Don't play my damn go!
Okay, wait.
I need her!
What this means? Forest.
you do if you were me?
It's closing time.
What? Wait. Do I have to go? I've got a lot to sort through.
Can you lock up?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, mount up here then. Don't start any fires.
Thanks, Dolores. What would you do if you were me? What should I do? Should I make everyone else happy or make myself happy? My parents expect nothing, but they want everything. Oh, what a dilemma. Is it better to live up to no expectations like my brother, or to take a risk and surprise everyone? Maybe I should just take off for the undiscovered country of Montana. Then, nothing's really resolved, is it? The guidance counselor says that I'm not gonna graduate. Megan says that in all probability we're done, finito. And my mom won't talk to my dad because he ran over a gnome. What was that my dad said? Any chainsaw can cut, but your chainsaw can heal. Is that what you said, Mr. Mordecai? Your chainsaw? My chainsaw? I don't even have a chainsaw, just my dad's. Not that he even knows how to use it. He bought it at a yard sale and couldn't even get it started, so I took it apart and found it covered in sawdust. Cleaned it out, put it back together. It works great now, but does it heal? Is that what you said, Mr. Mordecai? Chainsaw? It did make me feel better the day the guidance counselor told me I wasn't gonna graduate. Same day Megan dumped me. Same day Mom stopped talking to Dad. Man, I was so bummed out, I went home and carved the wizard dude in the tree stump. I was covered in sawdust and my ears were ringing, but I felt great. For a moment. You know, if only I could. Your chainsaw can heal. Wait a minute, Mr. Mordecai. I think I know what I'm gonna do. I figured it out. Megan, what are you doing here?
Pete, I felt really bad.
We're not breaking up.
No. I mean, yes, we are breaking up. I'm going off to college in 3 months. You don't even know what you're doing.
But I do know what I'm doing.
Really? What is it then?
I'm following the wise words of Mordecai.
Mordecai?
Mr. Mordecai, short fellow, very wise.
Is he a teacher, Pete?
He's a teacher of sorts. Got run over by a lawnmower.
Why would you joke about that? You make this up?
How could I be making this up?
You do some strange things sometimes.
Mr. Mordecai's a no. He came to me in a vision. Any chainsaw can cut, but your chainsaw can heal.
Would you stop that? You're upset because we broke up, and now you're being weird just to lash out.
Mr. Mordecai's gonna change my life. Whoa! Now you're saying weird things.
Look, I did what I thought was best for us. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you're right. It is for the best. You and me are gonna take very different paths in life. Listen, you've been a great friend to me, but now you're gonna do great things in Cornell, and I'm gonna do great at my thing.
Do you know what that thing is?
I think so.
Pete, I'm sorry that I said you were weird. You're not weird. You've been a really good friend to me, too.
No!
What was that?
The ghost of my father.
But your father's not dead.
No!
Listen, there's something I gotta do.
Pete.
Something really important. And I gotta do it now.
No!
Go on, Pete.
That's the spirit.
Oh my God. Oh, hey, Mom.
Pete, it's beautiful.
So you saw it?
It looks just like him.
I had to do it from memory since you threw the bottom half in the trash.
How did you do it?
Carved it with the chainsaw.
You carved that with a chainsaw?
Not bad, huh?
It looks exactly like Mr. Mordecai.
That's what I was shooting for.
Why did you do this?
Well, I knew how much the old Mr. Mordecai meant to you. I'm tired of you and Dad fighting all the time. It's hard to make any sense of life when your own family can't even get along. Not that it's the real Mr. Mordecai.
It's better.
I was hoping to get more time so I could paint it, make it look exactly like the old one.
No, don't. I like the natural wood.
But if I painted it, it would remind you of Grandma like the old Mr. Mordecai.
No, it's perfect now.
It is?
This one will still remind me of my mother, and it will remind me of you.
No.
What is that?
Ghost of Dad.
Does he still think he's dead?
Yeah, but I think I can snap him out of it.
No.
Well, when you see him, tell him I think I can forgive him now. Tell him to meet me in the backyard by Mr. Mordecai.
No.
And tell him to bring my sheet back.
I will help.
No!
Dad.
No.
Dad, it's time to end this.
End what?
This ghost business. You gotta stop being a ghost.
That one, Dee Dee. The ball's in your court on that one, Pete.
And you gotta stop this fighting with Mom.
I don't know about that.
What, wanna fight with her?
What fighting? We haven't spoken in weeks.
Yeah, why don't we start with that? Go talk to her.
No can do. I'm a ghost. No!
Stop it. You're not a ghost. You're not even dead.
I am dead. Dead of this.
No! You think I want to be a disappointment? Don't you think I want to do something with my life?
I know you do, but you seem so lost, and you've seen what happened to Lars. He's a 23-year-old cockroach running around my basement. Good grief. I'm living a Kafka nightmare.
Yeah, well, I'm not Lars.
I know that, but what's going to become of you? What are you going to do? Do you have any idea whatsoever?
I think so.
What is it?
I can't say.
Why not?
Well, it seems like once you say you're going to do something or be something, you're stuck with it. Once it's said out loud, that's it. Like, Megan's stuck in Cornell, Jordan's stuck in a septic tank, Shelby's stuck at Megamart, fractured hip and all, and Jordan's stuck like glue to a skateboard in our basement. I don't want to say it because I need to be really, really sure first.
Well, can you at least give me a clue?
This and this.
Really?
I think so. I'm almost sure.
Well, you'd be darn good at it.
Thanks.
You know, I'm feeling really good all of a sudden. I think I'm done with this ghost thing.
Good. You can go talk to Mom.
Oh, man.
I'm serious. She's in like a really good mood right now.
Well, I guess it's time, though I'm not really sure what to say.
Well, whatever you say, start out with, I'm sorry I ran over Mr. Mordecai.
Who's Mr. Mordecai?
Grandma's gnome.
Right.
Then I think she'll forgive.
You know what, Pete? You're a good kid. Do what feels right here. Not here.
Thanks, Dad. I will.
Well, I guess I'll go find your mother then.
Good idea. Wait. Don't forget the sheet. So, Dolores, what would you do if you were me?
If I were you? I'd get the pancakes.
You know what I'm gonna do? I'm going to Montana. Look at this. There's a Votech school in Missoula that has a small engines program. In 18 months, I'll be a licensed small engines repairman. And I can fix lawnmowers and weed eaters and chainsaws for a living.
And look at this.
In the same exact town, there's a chainsaw art school. A school for chainsaw art. And they have evening classes, so I can do it at the same time I'm doing the small engines classes.
And I can carve eagles and bears for the tourists.
And gnomes. And maybe I'll find a cabin in the mountains. And I can live there carving chainsaw masterpieces and repairing small engines. So, yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. And I'll have the pancakes.
What should I do?
I don't know. Go to bed on time? Whatever you do, don't tell her you're sleeping.
Have those Chicago papers delivered to our office on 42nd Street. Put the Penske file in the outgoing mail. And make sure that the triplicates of the Davenport document are fully processed and sent to personnel.
Yes, Miss Brown.
On second thought, Joe, why don't you head on down to personnel first? Pick up some termination paperwork. I might need it.
Certainly.
Didn't I ask for the Cincinnati report to be on my desk this morning?
Just head and do that now, Miss Brown.
Just one second, Mr. Hall.
Yes, Miss Brown?
You're late again.
Yes, I'm sorry. There were so many people on the street and my papers went flying.
What did I tell you about being late?
Miss Brown, please, I really need this job.
You'll never make it in the business world, Halt.
If you could just give me another chance.
Is it because I'm a woman? You think because I'm a woman I'm not strong, I'm a pushover?
It's not that at all.
It's the dog-eat-dog world, Halt. You gotta be tough. You gotta be able to stand on your own 2 feet. You gotta have drive and determination. You gotta push, push, push. We don't accept excuses in the business world. Either you get the job done on time or you don't. That's it. There is nothing else. Whether you were late because you were in an accident, or you got food poisoning, or you just slept in, it's all the same. You were late and the job wasn't getting done.
I can explain.
Are you listening to me? I don't want an explanation.
I want you to be responsible. I want you to be on time. I want you to stop thinking that the rules apply to everyone but you. I want you to stop thinking that you're special, that you're an exception, because you're not. I know exactly how you think. You think I'm exempt from the rules. I can be late because I'm tired. I can be late because there was a spider on my door. I can be late because I had a hangnail. And you think you're the only one around here who's tired. You think you're the only one around here who's afraid of an insect. You think you're the only one around here who needs a manicure. Let me tell you the reality of your situation, Halt. There are only two real reasons for being late. Number one, you think you're better than everyone else, so you don't have to be on time. And number two, you're simply not responsible enough to be on time.
Here you are, Miss Brown.
Thank you. I don't like either of those options, Mr. Halt, and you have demonstrated quite thoroughly that you are incapable of changing your behavior.
Miss Brown, please.
Donald Trump, you're fired.
Don't hijack me. You were supposed to meet me for lunch today.
Right. Here I am.
You're late. I have to be back at the office now.
Oh, come on, Joe. Give me a break.
That's all I ever give you, Don. You always say we're going to do something, and then it never happens. I'm sick of it. It's like you don't even want to spend time with me.
I do. It's just...
If you did, you would.
Joe, I just got fired.
I know. I processed the paperwork.
What you must think of me.
Well... Quite frankly, I don't see Miss Brown had any other choice.
Great. I thought that if anyone would understand, it would be you.
I'm tired too, Don. I'm tired of always waiting for you. Tired of feeling like you've got something better to do than to be with me. I'm tired of being second fiddle.
It's not that.
And I'm tired of excuses. I gotta get back.
Can't you stay a little longer?
What, you want me to get fired too?
Can I at least call you later?
I'm not gonna sit by the phone anymore, waiting for a call that never comes.
Joe, please.
You know, Miss Brown was right about the two reasons you never show up on time, but I would add a third one. You just don't care. Bye, Dawn.
Hey, Don. Here's the news. It's time to break.
Yeah.
The whole office is talking about it.
Well, that's just great.
Hey, don't worry. You'll find a new job soon.
Dylan, that was the third job I got fired from this year.
Hey, year's not over yet. Why didn't you go for four?
Very funny. Hey, you wanted to go get a drink or something?
Oh, I can't today. I've got a date. Don't want to be late for that, you know.
Yeah, good idea.
Okay. See you around, buddy.
See ya. You're telling me.
It's hard for a simple salesman like myself to ever make it anymore.
Join the club.
Oh. So you're a salesman too?
No, it's just hard for me to make it too.
Bad day.
You could say that.
Well, then perhaps I have something you need. Or perhaps not. Good day.
Oh, wait a minute. You'll never sell anything like that.
Like what?
like that, just walking away.
Oh, you seemed like you weren't interested, like you didn't need anything.
Well, you gotta make me interested. Just tell me something I don't need.
Sir, that's not really my style.
Well, then you'll never make it in this world.
Perhaps.
Well, show me what you got. Give me the pitch.
Well, I have matches. Glue. Cleaning fluid. This stuff is guaranteed to take out any stain. Mm-hmm. Wasn't there anything you need?
I could use a new watch.
Watches? Yes, I've got watches all the way from Singapore.
Oh, what's the point? I'll probably just lose it or break it. Besides, me and Time don't really get along that well. It's all because of Time that I lost my job, I lost my girl, and I lost my sense of self-respect a long time ago.
Sure, thanks. All the time.
That's an understatement. But it's not because I think I'm better than everyone else.
Of course not.
And it's not because I don't care.
No.
I'm just irresponsible.
You just need more time.
Exactly. If I had more time to get to work, then I wouldn't be late.
If you had more time, then you'd be on time.
That's right. More time.
Well, in that case, perhaps I do have something to use. Here we are.
What? I told you, I'll probably just break it. Besides, me and Time are enemies.
Don't worry, this watch is friendly.
It doesn't even have any time on it. It just says zero.
Sir, that watch doesn't tell time. It gives it.
Well, whatever, I don't even have any money.
I'm not in it for the money, sir. Good luck, Mr. Hall.
Yeah, good luck to you too. Wait a minute! How did you know my name? Alright. I told you I've changed.
What, in the last couple of hours?
Well, yeah, actually.
Look, Dawn, people don't just change over the course of a couple of hours. They usually don't change at all. But if they do, it takes them a long time to make that change, years even. And it usually takes something big to make that change happen, bigger than losing a job. And if and when they do make that change, it takes them a long time before they prove it to anyone.
Well, something big has happened to me.
Look, Dawn, I can't stand around here talking. I'm supposed to meet someone.
No, really, something's happened.
Yeah? Like what?
What if I told you it's so big that now it's impossible for me to be late?
I'll believe it when I see it.
All right. What's something I promised you that I never made good on?
Fine. I'll make it simple. 2 months ago, you promised me flowers.
I did?
And
Not only did you forget the flowers, you also forgot to show up for our date that night. Left me standing in front of the theater, waiting in the rain like an idiot.
Sorry, what kind?
What kind? What?
What kind of flowers did I promise you?
You weren't that specific.
Well, what kind do you want?
What are you gonna do? Go get them for me?
Uh-huh.
Right now.
That's right.
Half a dozen red roses would be nice.
Half a dozen red roses.
Yeah, this is a nice gesture and all, but you and I both know. Hey, you're never gonna get me those flowers. Oh, sure, you'll mean to, and then you're gonna be on your way to the flower stand, and before you know it. How did you know I would say roses?
I told you, I'm a changed man. Ask and you shall receive.
You don't have any chocolates hidden there in that coat, do you?
If I did, what kind would you prefer?
Actually, Dawn, I would like a coconut custard cream pie with whipped cream. Look, I can't stand around here talking. There's someone I have to meet. You're a nice guy, really. It's just that I think... What's that?
A coconut custard cream pie with whipped cream.
That's some trick.
I made it myself.
I don't understand. How did you... Why did you... What are you doing with that pie?
You asked for it.
I was just joking.
I know, but the point is, I got it for you. I'm a changed man. Whatever you want, I got it. I'm dependable.
Look, Dawn, you're a real great guy, but it's time I told you the truth.
The truth?
There's someone else.
You mean there's another guy?
Yes.
How long?
Just a few weeks.
You mean you were seeing him while we were still?
Yes. Only for a few weeks.
Is that who you're meeting? Is that why you're here, to meet him?
Yes. Dawn, please don't be upset. I don't...
Hey, Dawn. So this is a date? You've been seeing him behind my back? Joe and Dylan! My girl and my best friend! I see.
Hey, come on, Dawn. It's not like that. We didn't plan it, just happened.
Oh, sure. I understand.
Oh, man. Poor guy.
Yeah, well, he's wasted enough of my time. Let's just forget about him.
Say, what is this?
It's a coconut custard cream pie with whipped cream. Dawn made it for me.
Well, we shouldn't let it go to waste.
Thank you.
Termination paperwork on Donholt have been fully processed and sent to corporate.
What are you doing here?
Oh, I just thought I'd come back and visit the old place. Bring back some old memories.
Well, we are still a business here, Mr. Holt. You don't have time for you to immerse yourself in nostalgia.
That's funny, because I have all the time in the world.
Listen, Don. If you've come to beg for your job back, then I have won. To tell you, you can. As I was saying, if you think that you have one chance of finding a sympathetic ear anywhere around here, then. I'm afraid to tell you, it's more like Mr. Jenkins.
I'm over here.
Won't you just.
Miss Brown, I'd just like you to know that I hold no hard feelings.
That's very reasonable.
And you'll probably never see me again.
That's understandable.
But I'd just like you to know that every single day, until I get tired of it, of course, you're going to be experiencing some rather strange, no, odd, no, let's say incredibly perplexing things.
Like what?
Well, like this.
I must not be feeling that well.
Neither am I.
What do you say we just take the rest of the day off?
That may be the best. I wholeheartedly agree.
Well, let's see. This week, I got fired from my job. My girlfriend dumped me, and I found out my best friend was seeing her behind my back. On the other hand, I got this watch. Well, I guess it's time to start using time to my benefit. taking candy from a baby. And it's about time, too.
Don! Don, listen, I need to talk to you. I'm really sorry about what I did. I was a rat to go out with Joe like that, behind your back. And I understand if you never want to talk to me.
Really?
Yeah, I feel ashamed of the way I acted.
Well, are you still seeing her?
Oh, no, no. We ended it. I think she feels about as bad as I do. So, can you forgive me?
Yeah. No hard feelings.
Okay. See you around, buddy.
Yeah, see ya. What do you know about that?
Mr. Hall? John, can I speak to you for a minute?
Oh, what do you want?
I was thinking things over, and I think I might have been a bit harsh on you.
Really?
Yes, I want you to come back.
Well, what made you change your mind?
Well, the other day, some odd things kept happening to me, and I decided to take the rest of the day off. Well, corporate got wind of it, and they really let me have it. Made me realize that perhaps some circumstances are outside of our control. So what do you say? Will you come back?
Sure, Miss Brown.
Thank you.
And Miss Brown, I'll do better. Well, I got my job back. I got my best friend back. Now all I need...
Don! Hi, Don, listen. I've been a jerk, and I should have been more understanding. I know you probably hate me now, but...
Oh, not at all.
Do you think we could start over?
Well, I suppose so.
Thank you, Don.
Listen, why don't we have a night out on the town? Dancing, dinner, the works.
Sounds great. Well, but, you know, we don't have to go anywhere all that expensive.
Oh, no, it's not that. I have to do something first.
Oh, okay. Do you know how long you'll be, or...?
Oh, I'll only be a moment.
Oh, okay.
If we're really gonna whoop it up, I'm gonna need more cash. Oh, that's my god.
Thank you.
play What Would You Do was directed by advanced drama veteran Carolyn Young, so give her your...